Good afternoon, students. Today, the topic is binary tree traversal. This is an important topic under data structure course. So, for binary tree traversal, first we need to know what is binary tree. You know, for a binary tree, it consists of a root, a left subtree, and a right subtree. For example, this is a binary tree, where A is the root and this is left subtree. All the nodes belong to left subtree and this is right subtree. Now we have to traverse this binary tree. Traversal means the process of visiting each node in a tree exactly once. So this is a traversal technique. So in the next slide, we'll see different kind of traversal techniques. So there are four different type of traversal techniques. First one is pre-order traversal, next in-order traversal, next post-order, and the fourth one is level order traversal. For example, this is a tree where C is the root node and L denotes the left subtree of this tree and R denotes the right subtree of this binary tree. So pre-order, we can also tell it as CLR. CLR means first we have to visit the root node C, then left subtree R, L, and the right subtree R. So this is pre-order traversal. Then coming to in-order traversal. In-order is also called LCR. LCR means first we have to visit the left subtree, then C, that means the root node, then R, that is the right subtree. Then post-order. Post order means it is called LRC. That means first we have to visit the left subtree, then right subtree, then the root node C. Okay? And another, and the last one is level order traversal. Level order traversal means visiting the node level wise from left to right. That means level wise you have to visit the node from left to right starting from the zeroth level. That means from the root. In the next slide, we'll see detail about pre-order traversal. It is also called CLR. That means first root, then left subtree, then right subtree. And this is the function of the pre-order, where root is passed as argument. And then what is the logic? The logic is if root not is equal to null, that means the if the root not is present, then first we have to print the root item. Then we have to call the pre-order traversal, that means the recursive call will happen. And here the argument is root's left child. And then we have to again call the pre-order recursive call. And in this case, the root's right child will be the argument. So this is a sample binary tree. Now we'll see, we'll traverse this binary tree using pre-order traversal. So you know that first you have to visit the root node. So first A will be visited. You can see the color is changed for A. Then its left child B will be visited, next B. Next its left child D will be visited, next H, next I. So till now we can see that for this binary tree, the left subtree, all the nodes of this left subtree are visited. Okay, now we move on to the right subtree. So for right subtree, C is the root node, so first C will be visited, then its left child F will be visited, and for F there is no left child, so its right child J will be visited next, and finally G will be visited. So you can see from the at the bottom the list is given. That means in this order all the nodes are visited using pre-order traversal. Got it? Now coming to in-order traversal. Is it understood? The pre-order traversal?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now in-order traversal. Coming to in-order traversal. In-order traversal means LCR. First left subtree will be visited. Then the root node C. Then the right subtree, R. So this is in-order traversal function. The function name is in-order, and the argument is root, and it return type is void. The logic is, if root not is equal to null, then we have to call in-order function, that is the recursive call, and here we'll pass the argument root of left child. Then we print the root item, that means the root node. Then again, in-order traversal will be called, that is the recursive function, and here we'll pass as argument root's right child. So this is a sample binary tree. So first, to traverse it in-order method, we have to go to the left subtree. Okay, and for left subtree, we have to go to the leftmost child of this tree. So H is the leftmost child. First, we have to visit H, then its root D will be visited, then its right child I will be visited. Okay, can you tell me next which node will be visited?
B.
B.
Right. B. So B will be visited next. Next, its main root A will be visited. Then going to the right subtree. In the right subtree, can you tell me which node will be visited first? There is no leftmost node, but so which node will be visited first for the right subtree?
F
will be visited first. Then is right subtree J. Then C, then G. Okay, so this is the list for in-order traversal. Now coming to post-order traversal. This is also called LRC. That means first left subtree, then we have to visit the right subtree R, then the root node C. Okay, so this is the post-order traversal function. Again, the root is passed here as argument. Now the logic is, if root not is equal to null, then we have to call the postorder function, and the argument will be root's left child. Then again we have to call the postorder function, then the argument is root's right child. Okay, and finally we have to print the root node by this statement. So same tree, we have to traverse by using postorder traversal. So first, moving to the left side, and the leftmost node is H. First, H will be visited. Then its contemporary right child I will be visited, since left, right, root. This is the sequence for post-order traversal. Next, D will be visited. Next, B. Next, moving to the right-hand side part. Okay, the right subtree. So in the right subtree, first J will be visited. Since for F there is no left child, so J will be visited first. Next F will be visited. Next G. Next their parent C will be visited. And finally the root node A will be visited. So this is the list for post-order traversal. So the sequence is H, I, D, B, J, F, G, C, A. Got it? So we have seen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have seen three kinds of traversal, pre-order, in-order, and post-order. Now coming to the another traversal technique, which is called level order traversal. Here, for each level, visit nodes from left to right direction. That means for each level, we have to visit all the nodes in that level, and the direction should be from left to right. This is similar with BFS graph traversal. Okay, BFS means breadth first search. So breadth wise we have to traverse the nodes. Okay, so first at the zeroth level, root node will be visited first. Okay, and you can see the direction. First A will be visited, then from A to B, that means in the next level, level one, there are two nodes, B and C. First B will be visited, then C will be visited. Okay, then in the next level, that means level two, first leftmost node D will be visited, then F, then G. Okay? And in the final level, that means in the level 3, first H will be visited, then I, and then J. So this is the sequence for level order traversal. And this is the corresponding list. You can see this. The first A, then B, then C, D, F, G, H, I, J. Got it? Any problem? Understood? Okay.
Yes,
understood, sir. All the methods?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Yes. Now coming to binary expression tree. Basically, this is the application of tree traversal, binary tree traversal. You know that there are three type of notations. We can use it in any expression. The most common use is infix notation. That means first one is infix notation. X plus y, this is the infix notation. That means x and y, two operands are there, and plus is the operator. So binary operator means it operates on two operands. Okay, so x and y are two operands, and plus is the operator. Similarly, a similar expression in prefix notation is plus xy. Okay, so where operator will be situated at initial stage, at initial, that means plus, first plus, then the two operands x and y. This is similar with infix notation of x plus y. Then the third one is postfix notation, where the operator will be situated at last. So that's why you can see it is written over here xy plus. So these three expressions are infix notation, prefix notation, and postfix notation. These three expressions are similar. Now, this is an infix notation. We can represent this infix notation using a binary tree. This is called binary expression tree. Okay? You can see that all the leaf nodes are operand, and all the internal nodes are operator. Okay? So this way you can represent any binary expression tree. So here, in this expression, 7 plus 4. So 7 plus 4 we can represent in this way. 7 is one node, 4 is another node, and their parent node is plus. So it represents 7 plus 4. Next, it is multiplied with 2. That means this result, 7 plus 4 result, this result will be multiplied with 2. That means 2 is another node, and their parent node consists asterisk. Okay, so this is the result of 7 plus 4 multiplied by 2. And finally, it is subtracted by 1. So the whole thing will be subtracted by 1. 1 is another node, and their parent node is minus. So this is the final expression tree. So in this way, you can generate from infix notation to any expression T. Okay. Now these are the sample expression tree, binary expression tree. There are three expression trees are given. For example, we are considering this one. This is plus is the root node, and there are two child A and B. Suppose this expression tree, if we traverse this expression tree using in-order traversal, then can you tell me what is the sequence of this expression tree in in-order traversal? This should be A plus B. First A, that means left child will be visited first, then the root node plus, and then is right child B. So A plus B is the infix node, in-order traversal. And we can write it here. It is the corresponding infix notation also. So infix notation is A plus B. Okay. Now if we traverse the expression tree using pre-order traversal, then what is the sequence? First root node, then left child, then right child. So plus A B. So this is the corresponding prefix notation. It is written over here, plus A B. Got it? Now, if we traverse this expression tree by post-order traversal, then what is the sequence? The sequence is A is left subtree, then right subtree, then root node. So first A will be visited, then B, then plus. So this is the expression, Postvis expression, AB plus. Clear? So by traversing, by in-order traversal, post-order traversal, or pre-order traversal, we will get its corresponding notation. Similarly, for this tree, this expression tree, if we traverse in in-order traversal, what is the sequence? A asterisk B plus C. You can see it here in this table, in which notation A asterisk B plus C. Then for pre-order traversal, plus asterisk A, B, finally C. So plus asterisk A, B, C. This is the prefix notation. Okay? And for post-order traversal, A, B, asterisk C plus. That means left, right, root. This is the sequence. Then this way you can get the postfix notation. Okay? Now for the third figure, this is another expression tree, binary expression tree. You can check with this result. If we traverse this tree in in-order traversal, A plus B minus C asterisk D. Okay? So this is the result. Now for prefix notation, we have to do prefix traversal or pre-order traversal. So first, minus will be visited, this node will be visited, then plus, then A, left child A, then B, then asterisk C, and finally D. So this is the prefix notation. And for postfix notation, we have to traverse this tree using post-order traversal. So A, B plus C, D star, then minus. Okay? So this way, we can represent any binary expression tree, and from binary expression tree, we can get the defined notations, infix notation, prefix notation, and postfix notation. Okay? So this is the end of today's lecture. So we have discussed the different traversal technique, pre-order, in-order, and post-order, and we have discussed the binary expression tree, how to generate binary expression tree, and from binary expression tree, how to get the defined notations, infix notation, prefix notation, and postfix notation. So students, for today's lecture, do you have any question or query?
Yes, sir, I have a question. It is, why tree traversal is needed?
Okay, good question. Why tree traversal is needed? Tree traversal is needed mainly for searching. If we want to search any node, then tree traversal is very much useful. Okay? Any question next?
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir, I have another question. So what is the suitable data structure for implementing level order traversal?
Okay, this is also a good question. So level order traversal, we have seen, I have already told that level order traversal means it is similar with graph traversal. In graph, the BFS traversal, that means breadth first search. And in breadth first search, we have used Q. Okay, so Q is the suitable data structure for this kind of traversal technique. Okay, any other question?
Yes, sir, I have a question.
Okay.
Sir, what is the application of in-order traversal?
Okay. Very good question. In-order traversal application. Do you know binary search tree? Binary search tree, basically, it is a kind of binary tree, but the left child is less than, left child's value is less than its root node, and right child's value is greater than its root node. So for a binary search tree, if we traverse the binary search tree using in-order traversal, then we'll get the ascending order sequence. Okay, so this is very important to sort any numbers by using in-order traversal. Okay?
Okay, sir, thank you.
Then any question? Okay, no question. Now we shall move to our next section, which is quiz section. In quiz, the first question is, in pre-order traversal of a binary tree, what is the second step? I have discussed the pre-order traversal. Now, what is the second step we have to say? So, Shreyashi, can you tell me?
Yes, sir. In pre-order traversal, it is CLR. So, traversing the left subtree is the second step.
Traversing the left subtree. Let us see the answer. Yes, your answer is correct. Traverse the left subtree. Very good. Now coming to the second question. Second question is, for the expression, the n expression is given, 7 minus 4 multiplied by 5, then plus 9 by 3. Now the question is, find out the post-order tree traversal. Okay, so first you have to make this expression into a binary expression tree. Okay, now from the binary expression tree, you have to find out this corresponding post-order tree traversal. Shinjan, I am asking you, can you do this, can you find out this answer?
Yes sir, let me try, I need some time.
Okay.
So is it 7 4 5 9 3 star minus
7 4 5 9 3?
Yes.
No, it is not correct, sorry. Now Srija, have you done?
Sir, yes sir.
Okay, then can you please, you can say.
So, according to me, it's 7 4 5 star minus 9 3 by plus.
Okay, I think it is correct. Let us see. 7 4 5 asterisk minus 9 3 division plus. Very good. Now coming to the third question. In which traversal it visits root node last? Now Shamudip, can you tell in which traversal it visits root node last? Shamudip, are you present? Okay, next, Rumeli, are you present?
Yes sir.
Okay, can you tell me the answer?
Sir, in post-order traversal.
Yes, very good. This is the right answer. Next question. Which graph traversal closely imitates level order traversal of a binary tree? So I have already mentioned this. Now Supriti, can you tell?
Sir, BFS.
Yes, BFS full form?
Breadth first search.
Very good. Now coming to the last question of this quiz section. In a binary search tree, which of the tree traversal would print the numbers in the ascending order? I've also mentioned in the question answer session. Now, who will answer? Rajshekhar, are you present?
Yes, sir. It should be in order traversal.
Okay, very good. Okay, so this is the end of today's session. Thank you all.